The baddest DJ this side of town. Mixing the heat.
Ladies and gentlemen.
DJ Despair.
What up, what up, what up? This is DJ Despair, and I got my boy Richie Evans in the building.
How my you guy. Doing? I'm blessed, baby. How are you?
I'm good, man. So, like, we've known each other for a long time, and I've been Facts. Around you for your career since back when you were with Black Wall Street. Yes, so sir. How is it from the transition from Juice McCain to Richie Evans?
And you know the transition actually is great. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's just more of a growth situation. You know what I mean? Like when I was signed to Game in Black Wall Street, of course, you know, I was just a young, hungry, you know, kid trying to really, really just, you know, solidify his position, you know what I'm saying, in this whole hip hop ranks and really try to gain the respect and you know, success that every young artist, you know what I mean, is looking for. But like I said, man, now, man, I'm a more mature, grown man, very in tune with his business, very in tune with himself. And I think that I'm kind of putting out some of the best music of my life. So, you know what I mean? The transition has been wonderful.
Speaking on that. Okay. I like to get into a talk, get everybody, you know, introduce yourself and everything.
Yeah.
And then, you know, I want to get into one of your first songs. So let me talk my shit. All right. So let me talk that shit. What's up with that? How did that come about?
Let me talk that shit was a record that I wrote during COVID. You know what I mean? I felt like, you know, COVID did a lot of justice for me. Like I said, it really helped me organize my business, really centered me personally as an artist and as a man, but also helped me outline some shit. And basically that, you know, the record came about just coming straight out of COVID. I'm like, yo, I need a record that's really going to be in these artists' faces and let them know that, hey, man, you know, I'm really nice at what I do. Like, you know, despite me making records for the women and, you know, trying to crack the top 40 billboards and shit like that. Like, my nigga, when it come down to that pen, I'm still a rapper's rapper. You feel me? Mm-hmm. So, you know, that was basically the gist of that record. Let me talk that ish, man. And it really rejuvenated the name, the brand, and, you know, just really let people know that I was really about that action. You know what I mean?
All right, so let's get into a little clip of this.
You are now listening to Highly Favored.
You might as well run the motherfucking tape backwards. This is like, yeah, let me talk that shit. There's really not too many niggas quite like Rich. They compare to the greats, like Hov, like Nip, Kendrick Lamar. Plus I got bars like Tip, Cordially. My respect means more to me than faking on my wave like you really here supported G. I'm really hotter than your favorite rapper. I'm really realer than your favorite rapper. Check the stats, nigga. I'm 5 mics plus 1, that's no facade. Only name mentioned in mine is Biggie and Nas. On God. I'm a motherfucking problem. Any situation, I'ma solve. Rich.
Man. Come on, man.
So, ending there. What's this? You want to work with Nas so bad?
Yeah. Hey, yo, I got to be honest. You know what I'm saying? Nas is very influential in my career. You know what I'm saying? And he's one of the ones that I really, really give it up for. So, you know, it's always respect and love to Esco. You know what I mean?
So on that tip, like, who else do you want to work with? Like, now I heard you got a new song coming out soon with Rick Ross.
Yeah.
Like, yo, talk about that. Like, let's get into that.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You know, outside of, you know, Nas and Game and, you know what I'm saying, a couple of the artists that I really have the utmost respect for, but Ross is another one, man. You know, I've always been a fan of Ross. You know what I mean? I think he makes great bodies of work, and I think he's, you know, he's really dope at what he do. You know, when I was just kind of creating some of my buzz and building my brand, you know, he was somebody that I feel I sparked some interest in. You know what I'm saying? You know, I know the whole Maybach situation right now. I think Meek is over there at Roc Nation. Yeah. I think Wale is still at Atlantic. You know what I'm saying? There's a couple other artists, but I think that, you know, I've been moving in you know, the virals and the music has caught his attention. So when I got done, you know, making some records, man, I pulled up on him, let him hear some music. He liked it. You know, he felt like it would be something that, you know, he would have done. And he jumped on this record, man, called Can't Knock the Hustle. That's going to be on my highly favorite EP. So, you know, shout out to Ross, man. It's heavy.
So now it's been years since you've been away from the Black Wall Street, since you've been around past that persona. Now you're Richie Evans. Now, how is that now? How do you feel like being around now that you're your own man? You're your own boss. You're now. Like, you've always wanted this. Like, you were telling me at the beginning, like, when you were killing it in the mixtape game, and, you know, you were sending me tracks and stuff, and people were just catching on to the new image and the new change and everything. And now, like, you know, it's been, what, 5 years, and COVID has changed so much for you because people got to sit down and actually take in your music.
Yeah, 1,000%. You know what I mean? It was like I said, a big transition. Like I said, man, you know, you go from, I always say this philosophy, little monkey turns gorilla. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it always comes a time to where anybody in their own right who wants to stand on their own goes through a transition to where they gotta, you know, leave the circle that they initially started with. But like I said, man, for me, it's been great. I mean, it's been a long time. Don't get me wrong. I mean, you know, there's been a lot of ups and downs, some restarts, some reconfiguring situations. But like I said, you know, right now, I think that I'm really coming into my own. My business is good. My music is good. And I think that people are really starting to really get an understanding and really respect and appreciate who Richie Evans is.
Nice. So now, you've got this new track, this other track called Overdose on Arrogance.
Yeah.
I know how you are, so explain this one to me.
I got it from you, though, baby. I got it from you. You feel me?
See, what I've noticed in the game with you is, like, when I first got to meet you, just the hunger coming out of you and everything. Sure. And, you know, getting to know you over those years and watch you evolve and, you know, still being your friend to this day and everything. It's appreciated that I've got to respect you as an artist because you didn't give up. You didn't let the celebrity status even get to you. Like, you're just like, I just want to duck in the shadows. This thing has got me out here. Just trying to duck in the dodge. You know what I mean? Like, and now, so that was like, do you have artists coming out underneath you?
So right now the overall game plan is, like I said, we're dropping a highly favored EP. Then we're gearing up for my official solo debut album. And then I have a crew album. There are two artists right now that I've been dealing with that I feel that has that newer thing. You know what I'm saying? Of course, they got to work, you know what I'm saying, and put in, you know, a little bit of time and a little bit of grind work to really let me know they want it. But, you know, we are building a brand, a solid label, and there are a couple artists that we are going to put out up under that TEA imprint.
Nice. So right about here, I'm going to give you a little taste,
man,
of this Overdose on Arrogance.
Come on.
Let's go.
Give her that vodka, I chase it with that grapefruit. My vibe is a million, really, I'm on straight through. Louis V. Damier, young Richie Cassius Clay. The life of Pablo, swinging to my nigga, yay. My glow is infectious, my grind's on some next shit. You fucking with me, you know who you best. Yeah, confidence at the highest cost. You can't call yourself a boss if you ain't took a loss. And got it all back, pure stacks, all racks. It's all hustlers over here, baby, y'all facts. All arrogant, hopping out Carrera whips. Show you I will never miss Kobe.
Man, come on, man.
So on, man. Where did that flow come from?
Growth, you know what I'm saying? I was through that particular time, man, you know, just being a student of hip-hop, you know, I was experimenting different rhyme patterns, different cadences, you know what I'm saying, that really fit my vocal tone. And you know, I think at that particular time, honestly, like, I was really in a studying of Kanye. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I was really just trying to really, you know, break down some of his albums and kind of decipher some of the, you know, music that he's kind of put out. And like I said, man, I end up following that cadence a little bit, start experimenting, and the record came out hot though. You know what I'm saying? I think it's something dope, a little bit different, but strong.
So you consider yourself like a hood poet?
To an extent, you know what I'm saying? Like, don't get me wrong. I still, you know, I have my original, authentic Richie style, but also as being a genuine MC and a genuine artist, you know what I'm saying? I feel that there's always ways that we can get better and, you know, progress the culture. So like I said, you know, by me trying to get some different styles and different things like that, you know, ultimately just kind of evolves where I'm at as an artist.
Because I caught some stuff you've been doing on the side.
Yes, sir.
So you got this song called Can't Lose out right now.
Right.
Right. So that fell into my lap the other day.
Okay. I said, you really, really on it now.
You know what see what I'm saying? So I was like sitting there the other day and I was just like, from what you've been saying, it's like you go from let me talk my shit to like, okay, let me preach some shit. And right. then like the next two songs, you got, you know, you speaking to the ladies.
Yeah, now, man.
You see, watching you doing this right now and showing the diversity of a MC.
Yes, sir.
And a lot of people don't understand that back in the, like, when hip hop was really in its creative state.
Yes,
everybody
sir.
Everybody used to be in different, like, categories. Like, 1 minute they'll be on a pop track, they'll be on an R&B track.
Yes, sir.
On, like, so many different things. And a lot of people take away from that.
Yeah.
They think, I just got to be a thug, or I got to rap.
Right.
Or I got to be, like, hood and stuff.
Right.
So it's just kind of sad when you just look at like some of the artists these days, everybody sounds the same and there's no diversity.
Facts.
You know what I mean?
You know, it's crazy because that's one thing that I will, you know, admit, you know what I mean? That I really learned from Game, you know what I'm saying? When I was really his understudy was, you know, he was a real student of the Game. Like, you know, he listened to Dr. Dre, you know what I mean? He listened to Outkast, he listened to Wu-Tang, he listened to Jay-Z, and he really studied everybody's style that he can, you know, mold into his own. You know what I mean? It really showed the diversity of him being a true artist. So no, I'm totally in agreement with you on that.
See, that's one thing I liked about Game. He was a West Coast rapper that rapped East Coast.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And a lot of rappers at that time from the West Coast were not rapping like that at all.
No, at all. And you know, that I commend Game to that because honestly, that helped open the door for myself. You know what I mean? Like, I kind of have a little bit of that same similarity, you know what I mean, in me. You know what I mean? So, yeah, nah, shout out the Game for that.
Okay, so let me play around.
It's about to go down. This is a DJ Despair exclusive.
No, I can't lose. No, I can't lose.
I'm on a 100-mil mission, yeah. Sticking to the script, ain't changing my position. Move a little different, gotta follow my ambition. On this marathon wave, trying to double up my chicken, yeah. Young fly nigga on the lay low, with them off-white Nikes with the brains blow, with the rose gold rollie with the face froze. TEA chain sitting big with the bank roll. Yeah, I play it cool, my nigga. Even smelling like a million Jimmy Choo, my nigga. Yeah, I play it cool, my nigga. Even smelling like a million Jimmy Choo, my nigga. Yeah.
Man, come on, man. Man, come on. I got to talk that shit on him every chance I get, baby. Come on.
Oh, man. It's like I was telling my boy the other day, I go, what I love about you is that we could be in a room and you'd be like, fuck you, nigga. And the next thing you know, I was like, lady, come here. Let me talk to you. And then I've seen that in you because I've seen you 1,000%. Talk your shit and then turn around and be like, yo, shorty, come here for a minute.
Come on, man. Come give us some cool shit, baby.
You see, that's a lot of things that people don't understand is like, you know, a lot of people when they were starting on the Game, when you came out, a lot of people thought you were bigger than you were because you were rolling with certain people. But they didn't know you were still a struggling artist trying to get on.
Like,
you
know what I mean? Like,
even though you have that status and you had those people behind you, they didn't mean that you were actually there with them.
1,000%.
You
know what I mean?
So 1,000%. Like how many, 1,000%. Like how is it now, like, you know, when with COVID, like, it's opening up now and you're getting a lot of more recognition, interviews.
Yes, sir.
Like, I can't even go on Instagram without seeing you doing something now. So
which is good. You know what I'm saying? I want to first commend my team and, you know, really, you know, executing the blueprint and plan that we kind of set out. But second of all, man, you know, COVID with COVID, you know what I mean, kind of opening up out here a little bit, you know what I'm saying, where I'm able to move around and shake a little bit, it's really been helpful to break these records and to get my face known on a national level. You know what I mean? Like, I've been hearing that for the last month. Like, bro, every time that I wake up, we see you in HD, live and clear. You know what I mean? and that's love. You know what I'm saying? Because that just shows that, you know, one, you know, the music that we're making is really starting to resonate with people. But even also out of that, you know what I mean, they're able to, you know, decipher the music with the face. So, you know, I just gotta commend the team, you know, pushing through and thriving right now.
So how's it feel being on the Billboard?
You know, man, that's always been a dream. You know, no lie, man, it's always been a dream.
I know,
man,
a lot of dads' dreams is that, trust me.
Man, you know, it's a humbling feeling, man. You know, I was able, you know, this morning when I got back to the city, I was able to go down, you know, to downtown Phoenix, man, and just stand there and look up and be like, bro, like, that's me. You know what I'm saying? All them years and, you know, sacrifices and, you know, struggling nights of frustration, you know, really just kind of resonated like, bro, like you're really, really doing it. You know what I'm saying? You're really putting up numbers and the world is really appreciating the body of music that you're putting out.
So how did you get with Vito?
I met Vito a few times in LA, you know, before Vito was a solo artist, you know what I mean? He was a writer. You know what I'm saying? You know, Vito was known for a lot of smashes. The Usher and LMA record.
Yeah, I know his catalog.
the Chris Brown and Little Dicky record. Just a bunch of smashes. But I used to see him in and out of different studios when I would be in there helping other artists and, you know, writing records for people when he was doing the same. And we end up just swapping numbers out. And I went into the studio one day, man, I pinned up For You, but I needed somebody to vocally really, really bring it to life. And I started looking through my phone. I was going to call Eric Bellinger, but I just got done recording a record with Eric. So I was like, nah, let me try something new. And I was like, you know who got the vocal tone? Vito. Called Vito, explained the record to him. He told me to send it to him. He called me back 10 minutes later and was like, bro, this record is a smash. You know, he put that glaze on it. You know what I mean? And shit, from then on out, man, you know what I mean? Pandemonium started.
So trust me, I've been playing this record a lot, been working it. Like,
thank you, brother.
Like this, I played it for some people. They're just like, yo, like, what? Where he's back? Like, where did this come from? And I'm just like, yo, man, like, I had to just slap people in the face with it because I was just like, yo, this is a whole nother look.
It's a whole nother look, whole nother vibe.
Like, yo, I can't even wait. I got to play this now. So, yo, here
that's
we go.
All love.
Yes, sir. Jules, all up in your earpiece. I got some new for y'all. Richie Evans and Vito For You. If you rocking with it, bang my line. Let me know. 623-242-TEI.
There's not a situation that we can't iron out. I'm on a different type of level in life. I'm on that upper echelon, I'm trying to make you a wife. It's a secret society, all we ask is trust. Respect is everything and loyalty is a must. My name, whole weight, gotta move different. Put the rock on your hand, that's a cool ticket. Commitment, I ain't into really wasting your time. I'ma love you till the day that I die. Oh my, oh my. I ain't into really wasting your time. I'ma love you till the day that I die. Oh my, for you, for you, for you, for you, for you, for you, for you.
Please go to his channel and catch these videos.
Man, please.
I literally salute my brother right now because he's about to change the game in a different way.
I appreciate you, brother. Like I said, man, everybody tuning in, man, make sure you get that new For You single featuring my man Vito. It's called For You, available on all platforms. And like I said, we making some noise out here, man. It's doing heavy on the rotation charts for FM radio. We getting these major looks, you know what I'm saying, as far as the video go. So we working something special, man.
So what now, the whole Phoenix Suns thing. Explain that. What's going on?
Yeah, man.
What's been going on?
You know, this whole Phoenix Suns thing, I don't think people really understand the magnitude that surrounds it. You know what I'm saying? You know, Phoenix has never been, you know, in LA or Chicago or New York or none of, you know, never aligned with none of the mainstream cities. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, with the Phoenix Suns thriving and, you know, us getting a lot of national attention with me, myself, you know what I mean? And the 4U record getting a lot of recognition and, you know, a couple other artists out here moving and shaking, man. I think that we're really, really starting to gain the respect, the love and national attention that's kind of needed. You know, everybody's coming out here right now, man, being super supportive. And, you know, everybody's coming out to just, you know, help build the culture. You know what I mean? So, you know, Phoenix is growing, man. And, you know, I think we're really starting to finally come into our own and really be nationally on the map with some of these other states.
And you were on the cover of Overtime Hustling magazine.
Yeah. You know, man, you know. Shit. First it was Billboard Richie. You know what I'm saying? That was Cover Boy Richie. You feel me? You know what I mean? Got my verification from Instagram, Blue Check Richie. You feel me? So, you know, we over here, you know, knocking off the bucket list, man. We really up here turning shit up, man. Numbers is doing good, man. And we working, man. Head down, chest out, prayers up, and we working, baby.
You see, that's what, like, you know, when I've been doing Overtime Hustling for a while, like, I've been friends with these guys for a long time. I know, man. You've been in the magazine numerous amount of times, and
you've
been, like, interviewed by the team numerous amount of times. So it's like, when I saw Dollar and them have you on, I was just like, get out of here. Like it's my brother. Then everyone's just like, I started, because I was reminiscing on the pictures, because you saw them on the Instagram there. I was just looking at them one day, and I'm just like, man, this was a start of a dynasty. Like, literally, you said it. And you look at us now years later, like, it's literally there. So I'm really happy to actually still be along with you on this ride. And, like,
man, come on, man. You know,
you've been there in the beginning and understand, like, having those talks with you in the studio, like, you were real about it. You're like,
yeah,
you guys build, we will get there. You're like, I'm not riding off these dudes. I'm trying to do my own thing.
And, like, come on, man. You know what I mean? And I'm glad to this day, brother, that, you know what I'm saying, that we were able to make it through the storm to be where we at now. You know what I'm saying? It feels good to sit here and have a conversation with my brother about positivity, you know what I'm saying, on his own show. You feel me? I'm on your show. That's progression and growth all within itself. You know what I mean?
Well, so, like I said, game.
Yeah, man.
Like, when you were, like, when we were pushing you on mixtapes and I was playing you in the club still and stuff, and I was just playing you in my network, I didn't care what anybody was saying. And a lot of people were hating on us DJs because they were like, well, why are you playing these guys if they're nobodies? Like, or they're not even out there. They're like, eventually they will be. How do you think a person gets there? When Young M.A. first came out, Dave East and everybody, they were just jumping on mixtapes.
Yeah, 1,000%.
A lot of you guys were in the same circuit. Like, Megan, everybody was actually on just mixtapes.
Yeah,
and 1,000%. Just got their step one by one. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Some people got writers. Some people actually stepped up their writing game. You know, a lot of different things has gone on in the game. But, like, as you see things getting bigger, do you feel that you're still going to have control over who you are?
1,000%.
Individual?
1,000%. You know what I'm saying? I tell people all the time, you know, I think that one of the best gift and curse situations was me being signed to the Black Wall Street, because I was able to get all my young shit out early.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I think that I was able to, you know, sit back and watch and make a few mistakes and bump my head, but also recover from that. You know what I mean? I think right now, man, I'm just so focused and in locked in within self that, you know, I know the true root of this music. You know what I'm saying? I mean, don't get me wrong, man. We all in it for a paycheck and to really, you know, take care of our families. But, you know, I'm in it for the love. This is something I love to do. You know what I'm saying? This is something that, you know, yes, it is a business, but it's something that I love to do. And I respect it and appreciate it. You know what I'm saying? So,
true.
You know, I don't think that, you know, moving forward, you know what I mean, there's going to be anything drastically or anything crazy. I just think that I'm going to potentially keep, you know, pushing up the charts, man, and really just trying to do the right shit and give back and turn up.
So any movies, TV shows in your future?
You know, it's funny, man. You know what I'm saying? Hey, well, shout out the For You record. You know what I mean? Just got put on the Real Housewives of Atlanta and got on VH1. There's another show called Sasha Sunset that it got picked up on as well. I am trying to get into movie roles. I just got my first script to read, you know what I'm saying? To kind of, nice. You know, check out that I got to read and things like that. The EP is finished coming this summer. Like I said, we're going to go to Miami with Kool and Dre and, you know, sculpt the album together.
Nice.
Got a few endorsements and partnerships going, you know what I mean? I am booked for a couple tours already. So, you know what I mean? I'm booked and busy, man. And I'm humbled and appreciative, bro.
And, you know, staying busy and staying consistent is a big thing with you. And I've noticed that you have so many interviews,
yes, sir.
Radio shows. Like, can you explain, like, for real, how important it is to keep in touch with the DJs, the online radio stations, not just the FM stations.
Yeah, for
not
sure.
Not just the satellite for and, you sure. know, and podcasts. Like,
you know, one thing that I've learned through this journey, man, is, you know, the groundwork is the most important foundation of this whole blueprint. And that's, you know, like I said, staying in tune with, you know, doing your radios and your radio drops and making solid relationships with these DJs and really trying to be there and do as much as you can for them, as much as you're asking, you know what I mean, as they're asking from you. It's very, very important. That's what, that right there is what's got me to this phase where I'm at now.
True.
You know
True.
What I'm saying? I think the groundwork of doing these interviews and, you know, really being consistent, you know what I mean, and building these solid relationships has done nothing but help prosper where I'm at right now and, you know, catapulted me to where I'm at and where I'm going.
Because I've known you from the first time we met and everything, you were like, I only met fucks with a bunch, like certain DJs.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then when you put me in that same category, I felt blessed because at that time you were with New Jersey Devil.
Yeah.
You were with Drama. You were with like
Ski, DJ Ski.
There was a couple of times you called me in the studio with like so many different people.
Yeah.
And you know, and it's like, and you were always steady doing mixtapes. And that's the one thing I liked about it, that you were never afraid to like just keep going. Even though it was like, you know, and that's a lot of things in the game of people didn't know that mixtapes kept a lot of you guys alive.
1,000%. You know what I'm saying? Like the mixtape circuit is what's helped create half of our careers. You know what I'm saying? I mean, there's only been a few overnight successes, but like True. The mixtape circuit has really helped create, catapult, learn pretty much everything in this business. So, you know what I mean? Shout out to that phase, you know, of our career, because that definitely helped us understand what this grind was about.
Well, cause I was telling one of my youngins the other day and I go, do you understand that we were the first Spotify? And they're like, what do you mean? I go, think about it. We dropped a mixtape. It went on a mixtape site. We uploaded it ourselves. We put all your tracks on there and made them all tagged with your name and everything and links to go get them from your site. And then after, when you drop the mixtapes, most of us DJs were doing like 100,000 to 1,000,000 in like hours.
1,000%. Yeah.
You know 100%. What I mean? And now you look at it now and it's just like, why is it harder now to break a record? Like, you know what I mean? Like, than it was before. Like,
man.
Like, I remember when I was doing that thing, I'm just like, so how could I not make money doing that? Like, you know, later. Right. And that's why I stopped doing that, because it was a lot of like, momentum and like traffic and stuff that was going to people's sites that I wasn't making money off. So I was just like, why am I doing this? Right. Now that we're doing it on our own platforms, but people still trafficked after all of that to still go putting it on social platforms and not trafficking it to their own websites and their whole thing. Like, you know, monetization is a big thing right now. And
that's everything right now.
Getting pretty music much. Played on digital radio stations. A lot of them are ASCAP, and we've been that way for years. We've been BMI and ASCAP for years, and a lot of people never paid attention to that. You've been DJ conferences. Funny. You've been on DJ. You've been at DJ conferences, all different types of things. So you're still getting played no matter what, and you were still getting royalties knowing that you were getting played through the DJs and stuff.
1,000%.
And a lot of people didn't catch on to that until now.
Yeah, 1,000%. And, you know, but like I said, that's kind of how the industry is, man. You know what I mean? You got to fail early. You know what I'm saying? To learn from it and get it right. You know what I mean? For sure.
That's why I find it funny now that a lot of labels and stuff are trying to figure it out. Like, you know, jumping into record pools, jumping into different things and seeing what we were doing. Yeah. And then now they got all these like stipulations and criteria going on right now where they're going to be banning certain things. Like you can't even play certain music or certain content without it being, without you being even registered. Like,
now. Yeah.
So you have to actually have a registered platform to even do anything now for like play and promote artists. So how do you feel now that digital has changed from like how you used to just sling mixtapes and your albums on the street?
You know, I'll admit at first it was a hard transition at first. You know what I'm saying? Because like I said, you know, we came from the era where we were slinging mixtapes and, you know, we really wasn't on the camera like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, the social media platforms, like, you know, we was always, you know, we was in the streets, you know what I'm saying? You know, moving and shaking and grinding and, you know, trying to make it shake. But like I said, man, you know, it was a learning curve, but, you know, right now, man, I think it's the most respectful and best way, you know what I mean, for people to build their brand and make some money off of it. You know what I'm saying? I can't lie. You know what I mean? You know, you got to be consistent. You got to put out great, great product. But if you do those things, man, and, you know, some of these other small intangibles, sky's the limit. You know what I'm saying? Sky's the limit.
Perfect. So, like, now, where is Richie Evans going to be 10 years from now? Where do you see yourself?
Man, you know what I'm saying? Richie Evans 10 years from now. Shit, we ain't even got to say 10. We'll drop it to 5.
Okay.
You know, Richie Evans is going to be a household name. I think that people are going to respect and appreciate his story. He's going to be one of the few artists from Phoenix, Arizona to help put it on a national stand. He's going to bring a platinum or gold plaque to the city to be one of the first to do it. He's going to build a very strong record label called the Evans Administration to really put out some high fire ass artists. And, you know what I'm saying? He's going to be that guy. You know what I'm saying? He's going to have a network of businesses and other things going on, and he's going to help the people. And, you know, he's going to be legendary, brother. He's going to be legendary.
That's all I wanted to hear, man, because, like, you spoken well from the man himself. Right now, I just got to say is, like, I'm dying to work on something with you, which we will end up doing something eventually.
Yes, sir.
And, you know, it's like, I can't wait till you start hitting tours. Like, right now, how's your overseas looking?
I'm booked heavy right now. Well, so hey. So it's crazy because I was supposed to be doing my Europe tour July 22nd to August 24th, but their COVID restrictions have been extended.
Okay.
So what we did was we end up pushing it back, but my tour right now, I am booked from November 2nd to November 24th. So I got Manchester, London, Leeds, Glasgow, you know what I'm saying? I'm moving all over there. I know we're trying to get some type of run in Canada, but I know your guys' restrictions is a little bit.
I probably ain't bringing on you until, like, you don't like coming out here in the winter. So I know you ain't gonna be here until next year sometime. I'll tell you that straight. Because everybody's like, yo, Despair, trying to come up. I'm like, yo, you know, the winter is the only time they're gonna open up. And they're like, I'll wait till next year.
Yeah. Just like, but I'm gonna make sure, but you already know, man, I'm gonna make sure I come out there. And then, like I said, coming up, I know I got a few legs coming up in the end of July to August on this West Coast leg. So, you know, I'm locked in. Like I said, man, I'm booked and busy, man, and I can't complain about it.
Oh, don't worry about that. We got some things being popping in the Caribbean, Mexico and shit that I'll talk to you about later on. But
please do.
Like, you know, I'm looking overseas and everything else too, because right now I don't see much going on in here for the next bit. And, you know, and us crossing back and forth between the U.S., I don't see that happening until next year. Could happen it earlier, but you see, with the stipulations and with what's going on with like vaccine shots, passports.
All yeah.
That. We don't know what's happening. So right now I'm just playing it by ear because it's like even hard enough right now to go between provinces. Provinces. So it's like, we see what happens, but
yeah,
you know, like hopefully for the best, but I'm just going to keep pushing the music. Hey, you know what? We got to do it virtual. We'll do it virtual.
Yes,
you know
sir.
What I'm saying? Like it can be hard to put you up on a screen like this and have you perform. So like
I'm with all that.
All right, so right now we're gonna sign off. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. Richie, you want to give your shout outs?
Yeah, man, just want to give a shout out, man, to everybody that's really been supporting the Richie Evans brand and the TEA movement. Shout out to my team, everybody who's helping. You know what I'm saying? You know, push this whole campaign. Shout out to everybody who tuned in. Make sure you follow me on all my social sites, Richie Evans. That's at Who Is Richie on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Make sure you get my new single, man, called For You, featuring Vito on all platforms. And like I said, man, stay tuned, man. I'm coming to a city near you. It's your man, Richie Evans, live and direct. We on.
Peace. All right, I got you still. We off.
Yeah.